evidence that statins have other benefits besides, yes, they may reduce risk of Alzheimer's disease, they may reduce risk of some cancers. I think they are much, much more effective than any drugs we had previously to lower cholesterol and improve blood lipids. They are not totally benign. There are some side effects from them and problems in some people. Derangement of liver function and muscle metabolism, but I would say overall those side effects are fairly rare. There's some lesser known ones like global amnesia. I've seen a few patients with that. That's pretty alarming, but I think those the downsides are rare. At the same time, I don't agree with a number of cardiologists that I hear say that we should put statins in the water supply. For a lot of reasons. One is that I don't think cholesterol is the sole problem in heart disease. I talked about inflammation and in heart disease, actually more than cancer, I think we have better evidence for a role of emotions in causation. You know, we know that there is a heart attack prone personality in men. You know, men who have a tendency to rage when frustrated, for example, that has a good correlation with tendency to heart attacks. And if you just put people on statins, you're not doing anything about that, those factors, about, you know, all the other influences on heart disease. And I think for doctors, you know, giving a statin then excuses them from responsibility of dealing with everything else. I mentioned this natural alternative to statins called red rice yeast. It's very effective. It's a natural source of statins, but it's a mixture of statins, not a single molecule. And there's a lower incidence of side effects with it. Solaray makes a good brand of it. I would try that first before you use a prescribed statin if you want. Statins, in addition to inhibiting cholesterol synthesis, they block synthesis of CoQ10, a natural product that's needed in the body for muscle metabolism, including heart function. So anyone on a statin has to take supplemental CoQ10, and it's possible that it's depression of CoQ10 that results in the muscle syndrome that we see with in some statin patients. So that's what I would say. I mean, I think they're overall they're fairly effective drugs and fairly safe, but they're dealing with only one aspect of the problem, which is lowering LDL cholesterol. We are still without the ability to raise HDL cholesterol. And, you know, there's enormous pharmaceutical looking around for the agent that will do that. They haven't found one yet. But, you know, changing lipid profiles is more than just lowering LDL, and that's what statins do very well.